All right, so we're going to do two examples. The first is the example which appears in the textbook, and I've decided to add one more just, you know, for fun. So in the first one, we'll draw our coordinate axes. We'll label them x, y, z as usual, and extend out the negative y-axis here because we want to mark y equals 2 and y equals negative 1. Right? And now we're going to draw a couple of coordinate planes. And now this region, of course, we can't really sketch it because it's sort of infinite in extent, right? It goes on forever. We have this plane here. Right, here's the plane y is equal to 2. And then over here, we've got the plane y is equal to negative 1. Right? And the region in question is just, it's everything in between the two planes. Right, and that's a... It's not such an easy region to draw. Now, the next one is a region that you'll be seeing a lot of once you get to, say, triple integration. If you're seeing this in a calculus context. So we have three planes, right? One way to realize is that this is actually a region bounded by four different planes. X equals 0, y equals 0, z equals 0. Right, the three coordinate planes, plus this fourth plane here, 3x plus 2y, 3x plus y plus 2z equals 6. And we want the region that's bounded by all of those planes. Okay. Now, one of the ways that we'll do this is we're going to get the intercepts. Okay. So notice that if y and z are both 0, we get 3x equals 6, so x is equal to 2. So one of the sort of intercepts is here, okay? 2, 0, 0, okay? I could put x and z equal to 0, and I simply get y is equal to 6. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I get the point 0, 6, 0. And if I put x and y equal to 0, I'm going to get 2z equals 6. So z is equal to 3. So 1, 2, 3. So there is 0, 0, 3. Okay. So those are all points kind of on the edge of our region. We also get, well, you know, really it's x less than or equal to, you know, so x is between 0 and 2. So we really have kind of all of that, right? Y is really between 0 and 6. Z is between 0 and 3. So we have all of those. But we can also put, for example, z equal to 0. And then x and y, right, if z is equal to 0, then you have 3x plus y less than or equal to 6. You know, you can draw the line 3x plus y equals 6. That line goes through those two points. So we have that line segment there, right? X and y have to remain positive. And so we get everything kind of in here. Similarly, we could put y equal to 0, and we would get that line segment there. And we could put z equal to 0, or sorry, x equal to 0, and we would get that line segment there. So we get those three sides there in the coordinate planes, plus the sort of outer face of the tetrahedron, right? This sort of outer face here. Yeah, and this is, I don't know if I already mentioned that, but this is the shape you get is a tetrahedron. All right, so it's a four-sided shape. Each of the four sides is a triangle. And it's that sort of three-dimensional solid that you see there, right? And you'll see a lot of those later on in the course once you get to, say, integration in more than one variable.